It's time for a Boy and His Blob review. No, not this, the game. Sorry, it's time for a Boy and His Blob review for the Wii. This is a reimage of the 1989 A Boy and His Blob game for the NES, which I have never played. And actually, I've never even heard of this game until it came out for the Wii in October, so let's see how it turned out. The story is about a boy who wakes up in his treehouse, or tree mansion is probably more appropriate, and goes to a crash landing site of a meteorite and finds an alien who he calls Blob. And so of course, they become best friends. What else? The Blob has come to Earth in search of help because an evil emperor is threatening the Blob's home planet of Blobalonia, and thus finds the boy, and so your journey begins. This game is a pure 2D puzzle platformer. You will mainly control the boy throughout the levels. To get through the levels, you will use the Blob to help. How do you do this? Jelly beans, of course. You have an infinite amount of jelly beans at your disposal, and when you feed one of them to the Blob will change into a unique shape or object that the boy can use to get through the levels. Changing into different shapes and objects depends on which color of jelly bean you feed the Blob. There are many different shapes and objects the Blob can turn into, but the catch is that each level will only give you certain colors of jelly beans to work with. Some levels will only allow a few, while others will give you a lot. Because of this, there is a wide range in difficulty for each level. You have an infinite amount of lives, and checkpoints are everywhere, so don't worry about dying too much. The goal of each level is to find the golden sparkly jelly bean, which will end the level. There are 4 different worlds to explore, with 10 levels in each world, so there are 40 different levels. Oh, can I say it? Oh, I must! Hooray for math! There are 3 treasure chests scattered throughout each level. Each treasure chest will give you some new decoration for your tree mansion, or house, or it depends on which world you're on. If you can find all 3 in a level, then you are awarded with a challenge level. If you can beat that level, then you are awarded with numerous extras like works of art. The graphics are beautiful. I love hand-drawn graphics, and these are the best hand-drawn graphics I've ever seen in a game. The controls are very good. You can use the Wiimote Nunchuck combo or the classic controller. Both are good, but I mainly use the Wiimote Nunchuck combo. With some shapes and objects of the Blob, you can press the A and or B button to make something happen with the Blob. Like when the boy is inside the Blob, you can press A to make the Blob roll faster. You can press the down button on the D-pad to scold the Blob, which isn't really scolding, but making the Blob stay in one spot and not move. And you can press the up button to hug the Blob. Aww. It doesn't do anything, but everyone needs a hug once in a while. So anyway, for the majority, the controls work very well, but there were some instances where they would become unresponsive, which became annoying. Also, sometimes they work too slowly when you were in a fast-paced situation. The camera was good, but could become a problem in some situations. Sometimes it wouldn't keep level with the boy and the Blob, which can become a problem if enemies are shooting right at you and you can't see them. Also, the camera was kind of jerky when you would press up and down while riding the rocket Blob, which is my favorite form of the Blob. The boss fights were fun and could be quite a challenge. It usually didn't take very many hits to defeat them, but some of them can be very frustrating to beat due to some circumstances. You will have to use different forms of the Blob to defeat them. A Boy and His Blob is a very good game. Beautiful graphics, very good controls for the most part, excellent puzzling levels with a wide range of difficulty, awesome shapes and forms of the Blob to help you get through the levels, a good amount of replayability, and many extras. But some of the downsides that I found were the controls can become unresponsive sometimes, and can be a bit too slow in fast-paced situations. The camera could become a bit frustrating at times, the game is a little too short, there were too many loading screens, and I think the price tag is a bit too high. Now, like I said, there is a good amount of replayability by collecting all the treasure chests in each level and playing the challenge levels, but even so, I don't think this game is worth the $40 price tag. If it drops down to $30, $35 at max, then I'd probably say go ahead and pick it up. But right now, I think it's just too high. But overall, it's still a very good game that definitely should not be overlooked. I'd recommend it to anyone who loves puzzle games, and to anyone who enjoyed Wario Land Shake It like I did, I bet you'll have fun with this game as well. This game gets a 3.75 out of 5 with the title of Awesome.